Well, of course, when there's a problem, everybody cries for more money. We understand that. But in the Reading School District, we are very close to being financially distressed right now. The kids are receiving 29% less funding than all the other school districts in the other surrounding areas. So we are at a severe disadvantage. So when we have companies trying to come in to our city and they ask us where is the educational levels at for, you know, jobs, well, guess what? We're at a disadvantage. So we need to educate our children and then, you know, get them into the workforce. But, you know, when we can't educate them, how do we expect businesses to come into our town and hire these people? When I talk to small business owners in my hometown, one of the biggest problems they have is the 222 corridor leaving out of my hometown. And, you know, if businesses could, you know, use that road, if it was done properly, they could expand their businesses north, 30, 45 minutes, an hour north, that, you know, they'd be able to hire more people, create more tax revenue. But unfortunately, the area is just so tied up right now and congestion everywhere. All you do is sit and wait and wait and wait. And be honest with you, what happens when you sit and wait? And then these accidents happen and then people die on these roads. And then who's responsible for this? So we must invest in transportation, but we must invest in, you know, building new infrastructure system, not just maintenance.